Joaquim and Gustavo, all from the sector, and it has to do with the work considered main direction. I will make a brief introduction, contextualizing why we have done this work. Then I will present the master, a little description of the goals and structure. Then I will explain how we have collected and organized all our data. Then I will analyze it, present a case study, and then we will make the conclusions of this work. So, a few years ago, and within higher education, it was almost criminal to say in the same conversation higher education and employment, because higher education goal was not vocational. But, of course, one of the desirable goals of higher education is the transition to the market work, and the graduates expect to have worthwhile careers there. So the gap that there is between higher education and the labor market has to be reduced, and there are several studies nowadays that point to that. So in order things work well, there must be an effective information exchange between these two worlds. And some authors claim that it would be ideal that the employers should be involved in the design of the curriculum plans, so there would be a matching of job skills between higher education and employers. So, in other words, we could say that higher education should be shaped by the demands of labor work. So, according to literature, and that is our experience too in the as main direction, employers state that graduates have solid knowledge, either theoretical and practical, in their area of skill specialization, but they have a lack of what it is called nowadays soft skills or generic skills. So employers say that graduates lack of competences such as communication, time management, the ability to manage heavy workloads and stress, and so there is the necessity to develop these competencies. Some authors claim that this generation can be called as a Peter Pan generation, because when they arrive to the labor market, they don't have the commitment and the maturity as previous generations have. And they give a lot of importance to their comfort, to their personal life, free time, and don't not so much to the other things that they should do. So one of the ways that these skills can be developed is the introduction of a work-integrated learning program in the curricula of the degrees. Right? This program is a labor practice while the student is still at the university, and it is subjected to academic supervision and coordination. Another, and that is the general responses that institutions as well as universities as polytechnics are having to develop this kind of soft skills. Authors claim that another way of developing these skills is to live away from home or being involved in activities such as volunteer or participating in associations and things like that. So what we are doing, what we have done, is introducing one of these real programs in our master. So, the master that we are working is Master in Instrumentation and Metrology Engineering. It's a very recent master in Isabel. Its first edition, it was in the year 200, 12, 13, the first academic year where the master started. It has a wide range of student profiles. It has students with almost or even no professional experience and students with almost of 20 years of professional experience. Students that come from post-Bologna degrees with 3 years and students that have pre-Bologna degrees of 5 years and from various areas of engineering and not only engineering, from physics too and some other related areas. So they have different skills and they have different expectations about their future careers after doing the master. When the master plan was developed, it was before we arrived at the master direction, but when it was developed, it took in consideration the developing of these skills. So some of the curricular units have little projects that the students develop either in group or individually to try to develop these competencies. And it was introduced a real program in one of the curricular units of the last year. So here you can see the study plan of the master. You can see that on the second year there is a curricular unit called Dissertation Project Professional Training, where the students can go into companies if they want and develop these skills. So, at the end of the first year that the master started, so at the end of the 2012-13 academic year, about May, we had to define a procedure to find a place in this curriculum unit for each student. So what we have to do was to find a project for each student, either that developed here at the ISAPS Research Laboratory, so the students preferred a project, or a position and a team in an institution if they want to be involved in professional training. So what we did, it was first contact by email lots of institutions. We used the contacts from the social network of the physics department and contacts that we had from previous projects. And we also contacted some companies for the first time. We thought that they were companies that were nice for us to have our students there, so we contacted them by mail. Our mail, it introduced the master, the description of the study plan, the goals, the skills that the students were expected to have at the end of the master. And then we talked about this real program and asked them if they were interested in having our students there. And we suggested a face meeting for further enlightenment and for us to visit the company and know the facilities and try to see what were their needs so we could adjust the teams. So most of the companies were very receptive to our email, and so most of them were willing to accept our students. So we spent quite a lot of time visiting all these companies and knowing their facilities and knowing their needs and trying to establish protocols. About the same time that we sent the mail, we also contacted the students by mail and asked them what were their preferences. If they preferred to develop a project here at ISAPE, or if they preferred to go to a company and develop a personal, professional training, and if they had any preference of area and institution. Then we asked main teachers and researchers to give us teams for projects, because we were almost expecting that some students would prefer the project to the professional training. When we had all this data, we made a list of all the projects available, all the institutions and the teams available. And then we informed the students by mail, asking them what was their preference. After that, and after having this information, we have another meeting with all the colleagues of our department and the teachers of the main, and trying to find academic supervisors, because these programs, although developed in companies, they are coordinated and supervised for ESLEP teachers. After that, we assign each student with a topic, institution, or a project according to their preference, and a supervisor. We inform the students, and if by some reason they were not comfortable with the supervisor that was made to them, we changed the supervisor, so there was no problem. After this, we schedule a meeting in the company, and in that meeting there was the students, the main direction, the supervisor from ISEP, the supervisor from the company, and one or two other persons that the company thought it was important to be. In that meeting, we briefed the topic and more or less said, established the working plan, and the protocol between the company and ISEP was established. And by that point, the student starts his professional training and is monitored by the academic supervisor. Is monitored continuously, either by email, by Skype, or with by face meetings, okay? And at the same time, main direction supervises the whole process, so if there is any kind of problem, we can intermediate it without further problems. So, after this process is concluded, and it is just the beginning of the procedure, we have a research question, a question that we wanted to be asked. We introduced this problem with an objective to help students with low skills. So our research question was, is really the real problem useful to support general learning skills, and does it help students to enter the labor market? So, what we did, it was to collect data, all the data that we have from students. We use Portal's database that has all information, okay? The timetables, the number of students enrolled in each subject, grades, etc. And our data has just 2 years because, as I said, master is quite recent. It was from the 2013-14 and 2014-15. But the data from the second year is not complete because when this paper was written and submitted, the year was still going. So, here is the data that we have collected. So, as you can see, the number of students involved in the master is not very big. So, in the first academic year of study, we had 23 students enrolled in the master, but 7 of them quit the master. So, at the end of the first year, just 16 of them could be enrolled in the curriculum dissertation project. In the second year, the numbers are more or less the same, but the number of give-ups is not so big. The students give up, as we could see, not because they don't like the master, but because lots of students are working at the same time. So it's very complicated to manage both things, and some of them just give up. So, the number of students that was really enrolled in the curricular unit dissertation project training, it was 11 on the first year and 19 on the second year. And as you can see from these columns in the table, the number of working students in these names is very large. So, after this table presents the preference of students, okay? 4 students out of the 11 decided to conduct or to develop projects here at ISEP, conducted by ISEP teachers. 3 decided to do the project in their own companies because they work there, so it's easier. And 4 decided to go to other companies. And the numbers for the other year are this that you can see here. So, the students that have really completed this curricular unit in the first year are 6. So, as you see, lots of them didn't complete the curriculum unit in due time. In fact, just 26% of the students that were enrolled in the first year could complete the master in due time, because lots of them, as they are working, they can't. And 2 conduct, finish a project, 2 they work in their own companies, and 2 in other companies. From the students, 67% of the students that have completed the curriculum unit are working students. So now I'm going to present a case study. When we were first thinking about contacting the companies, one of our main students, one recent graduate student from the degree in Meteorology and Instrumentation, a three-year degree that we have here at ESF2, she applied for a position at Caetano Aeronautic. At Caetano Aeronautic, which is a company that is very well known in this specializing manufacturing airframes for military and civil Airbus planes. She said to us that this company was going to increase the meteorology department and so to need more students. So we contacted the company, and at September 2013, another student started there a real program. By the same time, another main student started there a position, but being guided by the company. And after that student finishing the program, she stayed in the company. And in September 2014, another student started his real program and stayed also in the company. And the company has already asked main students for more students, as well as for real programs, as for IELTS. So in a period of just 2 years, four main students are at that company, and the company is using us as an hiring mechanism and wants more students. So, conclusions, before I'm killed. So, the procedure implemented was quite time consuming and somehow difficult at the beginning, but it was quite rewarding. First, main direction is being used as a personal hiring mechanism. At the beginning, we had to find positions for our students at companies. Now it's the other way around, almost. Companies ask us for students for their companies. Protocols with companies were established considering equipment, installation use, study visits, seminars, etc. And with the feedback that we had from companies, we had a little reformulation of the plan, of the Greek work plan, considering all the feedback that we had, and we used the persons from the companies to aid us in that study plan formulation. Students benefit from it, they develop generic skills, and a significant part of them is IELTS. So, just for finishing, the results indicating that this introduction of a real problem in the master, it was really good because it developed generic skills in students and helped them to translate to the labor market with ease. Okay, thank you very much.